Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Vault. Today, we go to the Nether, like I said, but there are some updates. I died in my last world, so now we're in a whole new world. In this world, we have this little house here, which I built because I didn't like building it underground stuff. Even though this is still underground, it's a bit better. I like how the design that I made. This has nothing on top of it. It's just an observatory. Everything else is in the bottom. We might expand this out in a moment or later on when I'm off screen. But this is what we have here. Don't know what we'll go up here, but it's just there. Over here, we have a villager breeding farm. Literally all this does is make me villagers. Because inside of our little house here, that's all we have. I'll talk about this in a bit. But down here, what we have is just a villager trading hall. So I have not all of them, but most of the professions that I need them to be here for things that I need later on. Such as librarians for the enchanted books that they sell, armorers that I have to get to upgrade my diamond armor that we don't. We have just basic diamond armor here, which kind of sucks because it gives me no protection against anything. That's pretty bad. And for arrows, so I can get quartz arrows, which give me slightly increased damage and knockback, which is good. Now this torch right here is called a torcherino. It's mod that I added just to make things speed up for me because I don't like waiting, and the longer I wait and the more I die, everything takes way longer to get back to. So this is what I have. I also have a time in a bottle from the mod time in a bottle. Pretty much it speeds the same thing up, but except this is a whole area of things I can light up. And the time in the bottle does something specifically just to one block so that it goes faster, and you can make it go even faster the more time you use. This thing right here is called the trading post from the mod trading post. Pretty much just all gathers all of the villagers around you, and it puts it into a little neat UI here so you can trade everybody for items that you need, so you don't have to keep going down to them. It's easier for me like this because I have a lot of them over there, and then I could just go over here to trade everything near my items over here. These are crates from Quark. These are from Quark Oddities, I'm assuming, because you can't get these in a normal Quark. I would say add it because it doesn't really do any harm because it's still not a storage system at all. It's just crates that can hold a limited amount of items, as you can see up here. I changed the config file to say 100,000 because that's just how I like it. I like to store everything conveniently in spaces until I get a storage system. And doing it the normal way is just going to make my head hurt a lot. So that's how I have that. Pretty much anything else that I start adding, I will tell you. But for now, that's all I have done. And for me right now, what I have on me, I've changed my talents a little bit. So you have Dash now and Vein Miner. So those are two things. Dash just makes me go forward in a specific direction. Helps with elytras as well. And then we have experience. They give me the plus 50% more experience from anything that I get. And I have Twerker for things for Vault later on, because Vault uses a lot of items, it seems like. And me doing this in hardcore, I'd rather just have that instead of more vein mining. Here's my little farm down here. I shift, hold shift, and then everything grows. This doesn't grow, unfortunately, because I think I need immersive engineering as knowledge for this. But everything else grows, as you can see. Everything works, and then I can harvest this with my enchanted items. Now, for my enchanted items, I have this one. This is a diamond pickaxe that never breaks because it has mending on it, which is amazing. These have breaking, fortune, and efficiency 3. And my diamond sword, which I hope to get sharpness on it, has sweeping edge 2, unbreaking 3, and fire aspect 2. Then over here, we have my diamond axe, which has most of the same things as pickaxe has, so it's not really special. Our main goal today is to get enchanted diamond armor and then go to the Nether and hopefully not die when getting these blaze spawns. Because once we get blazes, we can start doing the end dragon. And I want to have enough gear possible to do that without dying. So our first goal here will be to add this. So right now, I'm just going to go over here, pretty much just take this out, and then put our Nether portal right here, because if this works, we don't have to really have it outside, which I think is more of a danger to my villager breeder more than anything. So 1, 2, and then I need one more like that, right? And then click, works, amazing. So our first thing to do is to get ourselves armors. Well, we already have armors. Our main goal is to spend all these it's emeralds. I won't use a trading post for this because mostly I have to go like this. I can do redstone. I already had these configured so that they don't refresh their trades. So pretty much all I have to do is that. I'm going to be spending a lot of stuff here that I don't need. Back, we've got all of them to master now, so now that we have this, we can go diamond. All right, diamond armor right here. We have unbreaking, hopefully this is the first one. So we have unbreaking 3, protection 2, which we want, projectile protection 2, which we don't want. I guess I'll take it. Unbreaking fire protection, protection 2, unbreaking 3, unbreaking protection 1, blast protection, protection 2, unbreaking protection 2, and fire protection. And I think that's all we have. Now this might pose a problem because we have little to no protection. Well, we do have protection, which is good, but not on all of our pieces. But right here, I have bought some stuff here as well. Luckily for us, we have 95 levels from doing a lot of trades. So that shouldn't be a problem for us mostly. I just have to buy the rest of the gear that we're going to need for this. I also need to make a chest so that it doesn't get caught into that little loop that's happening with that crate. So I'm gonna need a chest right here for all the diamond stuff that we're going to be needing. So that's most of it right there. I can double chest for that, put that away, and then we could start. We have fortune 2-3 books up here because I'm trading them later. But yeah, we can also get protection books from our librarians, but mostly I want to get it for sharpness, because once we get sharpness, we're pretty much so golden. Most of these swords as well don't have any sharpness on them, which kind of makes me sad. And I made this sword right here. So all these made this one, except the knockback. I don't really like knockback on my swords. But yeah, there you go. So these are what just happened? How did I just equip that? What the? I could do that? I could just right-click the equipment in here and get it out? I have never seen that happen. Also, a little automation for the materials we don't need. Just get shoved into this crate right here. And now we have 86 nuggets. Pretty cool. Alright, so now we have to do a lot of more trades. It's just gonna be a pain in the ass just to get all the armor sets. What I wanted to do is make a chicken farm, because I can cram. I think I made this world specifically to do 100 entity cramming. So I could have 100 chickens in there, make them spawn, get them killed, etc., etc. That would be pretty nice, right? There's some other stuff we can do. So there's some trades for wheat, of course. We could do a sugar cane, and some other stuff. But the reason I'm doing this mostly, because once we get into research, we can go into what we call easy villagers, which allows me to make them into one block stuff, so I don't have to worry about trading them as much as I am currently. And I can easily breed them, trade, and et cetera, et cetera. They can farm for me as well, which would be really cool. But this is why I'm trying to get this. This costs 3 research. So hopefully we can start getting into Vault Hunter soon, the actual mod pack. There's some other stuff here. So we have storage. I don't know if mechanism is not here. I think it's, where is mechanism at, actually? That's mining gadgets, queries, guard enclosure, laser mining. Where is this at? I don't really know. It doesn't really tell here, this mechanism. Mechanism can process ores and quintuple the outcome material. It also provides quick energized smelters and crushers, as well as interesting storage additional add-ons. So this is, I think, this would be the most important mod that we get from Vault Hunters. Then we can go into industrial foregoing, which allows me to do a lot of stuff with farms. As you can see, hot farms and enchanting and disenchanting. I don't know what automatic genius is. That'll be pretty cool. Unlocks refined storage, applied energetics, art, tools, utility, creative mechanisms. Auto crafting possibilities. That's interesting. Does that all that? Dimensional storage. Okay, I'm getting sidetracked. That's not the case though. So we can't do everything in mechanisms, like mechanism generators aren't part of the mechanisms itself. But this is all we need for right now, mechanisms itself. Decorations, I think, I don't know, decorations maybe. Maybe chef. Test dummies I don't need. More lights maybe, decorator. Make the house more furnished. All I know is that I don't need more chests at the moment. But we do need the mechanism. This is interesting. I've had this before, but it's not really... I don't know how to explain it. It's kind of weird. But besides that, let's start trading some more, and then hopefully we can get everything that we need ready to get our enchanting done. Right now I have 95 enchanting levels, and this is not going to be used for what we need. But with all this, this is just straight up unbreaking. I think one of them is, can I go unbreaking 4? That's the real question. No, only unbreaking 3. Okay. So most of these I don't even need. Like, I already have this legging. And then we just have a lot of other ones that we don't really need in there. But I'm going to go start getting these traits done for these villagers. I'll be right back when it's done. That might take me a while. Hopefully not. But hey, who knows. Hey, so what I've done is just made a ton of farmers. Because I need them to get more emeralds. So this is just farmers galore. This is just a trading post. They just are supposed to sell me wheat and stuff. And that's it. So pretty much where we have to go here is get the things that we want. So obviously we want this projectile protection 3. We want projectile protection 2, obviously. And then protection 2, unbreaking 3. We can go for those. All right. And then what do we want to add on to that? Well, fire protection sounds pretty cool. Let's get that. I don't know how far we can go with that, so we'll get 2 of those. This has unbreaking and projectile protection 2. So I can make unbreaking 2 and projectile protection 3 right there. Unbreaking and projectile protection. We'll get 2 of those. Just to get that done. And then this is protection 2, which makes protection 3. What you're going to need. Over here, what do you have? You have protection 2 as well. As we're going to make protection 3 boots already. This one gives you protection 2 and unbreaking 2. So this one is something we do need. We're going to add that to our thing. Unbreaking and protection. We don't have normal protection, so we can get those. Make that on protection 2. Blast protection. Maybe we want that. And then the last one gives us what? Fire protection, which we already have. Fire protection 2, which I don't actually have. I might grab that. Break unbreaking 3 and protection 2. Don't know if I want that. And then protection 2, which we already have. This one has protection 2. And then this is unbreaking. Maybe we can get protection 2 again, just to make protection 3. I need 18 diamonds for that. Let's see if there's a trade I can do right here for that. Alright, there we go. So then you sell the protection 2. And then we can start making this armor now. Now we have to leave this area. Bye bye, villagers. You were of use of me. So, go back to our anvil, which is damaged. Hopefully that doesn't do anything. So fire protection and fire protection. Fire protection 2. We have unbreaking here and that to make that. From there, we add these two together. And then these two together. I guess not. Why won't this protect? Is it because of the fire protection? Why is it not working? Did I do something wrong? I did do something wrong. So I can only have projectile protection or fire protection. And since we're going to the nether, I think I want to keep that on. So we keep that right there. So, we have protect unbreaking, projectile protection 2, and then blast protection, which I'm assuming don't mix together. Yep, okay, so we could just do that. That makes our projectile protection unbreaking 2. We'll keep that right there. Unbreaking and projectile protection. Do these fit together? Obviously, we want that to be protection 3 for our little boots. And there goes the anvil. Thank you very much, anvil. Let's just make another one. It's not so hard to make another one. Is that 333? That one's not 3. Alright, new anvil time. Yep, there we go, bam. Hello there, new anvil. Alright, so we have our protection 3 boots. Maybe we want to get feather falling for those. We'll see. Unbreaking 2, projectile protection. Well, okay. So this one, which we have a lot of stuff here for. I don't know if protection will go on to projectile protection. It does. Okay, cool. Okay, we're in the clear then. So then we want to go something like that, something like that, and then something like this. Oh, no, wait. So we do lose protection. I think I want protection, because I already have projectile protection on that one. These are the only two that are giving me protection, actually. So now with that, we are good. I think I should be able to resist a lot of damage, is what I'm hoping, right? Because this gives me fire protection. This gives me unbreaking. Well, they all have unbreaking. This one gives me projectile protection. This one gives me protection 2. And then this one gives me protection 3. I think I want to get another protection 2 R leggings so I can make protection 3 on that one. Maybe get this one to protect fire protection 3, just like this one. Oh no, this one does prop protect out protection. I just want to get this as the fire protection 3. This is protection 3, and then this one's fine because I don't have anything for that. So we can put the rest of this away because I don't need it. Maybe I do have something here. Okay, so we do have protection 2s here. So all I need is here. Go over here. Take them off, obviously. And then bam, bam. Go. Perfect. So now this should be giving me armor. This one for fire protection. I don't think I bought any of those. I don't know if I can make a fourth version of this. Maybe. We'll see. So my thing is, I don't know if protection goes up to 4. Oh, it does. Okay, cool. So that means I need to get this to 4 as well. Just to be safe. So 2 and 2 like that. Bam. 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 That's 3 already for some reason. Which I just need 3. So this is 3. This one I need to put on front. No, I gotta put this in the back. So that protection stays. Okay. So why did it stay as protection? Are these projectile protection? No, these are both protection 2. Why is this projectile protection? Get this out of here. Protection 2, protection 2. Right? Oh my god. This anvil keeps breaking on me. I need a better anvil. 1, 2, 3. Grab all that again. This anvil sucks. I hate anvils. Put him back. 1, 2. Protection 4. I don't know why that was so... didn't do that correctly. But there we go. Now that's on us. Now we need to get the fire protection. So I only have 37, unfortunately. 49, apparently. Helmet. So this one gives me projectile protection. 3. We're looking for fire protection. So helmet. Fire protection. It only gives me 2. But this is 14, so I can get 2 of these already. Right? All I need is 2. Right? Okay, cool. So let's bring that out. Bam, bam. Alright, perfect. Alright, so we're good to go. Hopefully, we don't die in the nether. For this not to be a waste. Because this took me a long time to do. So now all we have to do is go to the nether, which I'm scared about. Let's put away the stuff we don't need, like a potato in our inventory. Let's put away these villagers, obviously. Don't need them on us. I think I'm good to go. I want to buy more golden carrots first, though. Okay. Random Enderman. Hello there. Alright, let's go. Hopefully we don't die. Hopefully there's not any mobs that are super special that'll kill me instantly. We do have our golden carrots on us. We can get golden apples later on. And I can already see this spawn is kind of weird. Oh, wow. Okay, we have to move. Like, as quick as possible. We need to get... Yo, what is this spawn? This is like the instant death spawn. You come in here and die instantly. Alright, so I gotta take care of that lava. Here's some basalt, so I don't know if I'm near ancient debris or not. But let's close that out. Wait till that goes away. That was like... I wasn't going to react fast enough or I went off the keyboard. I was going to die instantly. I do see some gold ore up here, which I'm trying to get right now. Okay, perfect. So I need to be extra careful here. Let's instead make a bridge so we can go here. That works. So I can come up later, and then we're in a new area. Basalt deltas. There's the Enderman. Don't want to look him in the eyes. That'd be extra dangerous. Here comes the foxhound. There he is. That wasn't it. Yes, sir. Stood no chance. I hit that boy once, and he disappeared. All right, so there's pigmen. Obviously, we don't want to fight those. Get this out the way. Trying to attack me. How dare you? So our main goal here is to find a stronghold. There's a piglin right there. All right. There he is. He's over there. But I don't know if he attacks you on rip. Oh, he does attack you on rip. Okay. Relax. Relax. I didn't mean it like that. Relax. I have 552 gold nuggets. What am I going to do with that? I need to make a lot of stuff here so I don't get lost. It's the stairs. I just need to find a stronghold or something like a bastion. Oh no, you scary mother. You just came out of the blue and hit me. You asshole, you scared the living fuck out of me. We found it. Fortnite, right there. Okay, so this is the closest we're gonna get. Right? There are piglins here. So this is the actual fort. It's above me. Okay, there we go. A terrible fortress. We're in. There are chests here. Ooh, a saddle. 3 diamonds. Oh, perfect. Okay, so we could just loot this for armor and saddles, which I do actually need. This thing doesn't look like it has blazes in it. Which is weird. I would assume it would have blazes. I guess not. Maybe this fortress just sucks. Maybe I'm just blind. I don't know where the blazes are. Block that off. That's dangerous. Looks like that has a blaze spawner. So here's the blaze spawner, actually. Blaze is what I'm going to call this. I have to be sure I don't die when I'm going over here. Let's plug that up. Alright. There we go. There's a blaze spawning. Perfect. We'll have to go find a fortress later on. Alright, how many actually do I need of this? I don't have looting on this. Okay, okay, relax. You do no damage to me. I find that funny, right? I don't want them to come out. But I do want them to spawn. And I think this is a good way of doing it, so maybe I can come over here. Yep, mm-hmm. This doesn't hurt me, which is good. Actually, I don't even have to care about them. Come on. Oh, what hit me? Oh, no. Okay. So I can't get too close to them or I'm going to take damage. Get this bar out the way, please. Oh, no. I am taking damage. Oh, maybe it's because of the saturation from the gold carrot that's actually allowing me to take those hits. Gold carrot for the win. Hey, this is going to be the worst fight ever. Oh, oh, no, 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 no. Don't come out. Don't come out. Oh, great. Now they're out. Now it's gonna be more of an issue. Come on. Jesus Christ. This is just a pain in the ass, honestly. Can I hit him? Thank you. Jesus. There we go. Jesus Christ. Okay, so I gotta prevent them from... What's the zombie Pikmin doing here? I need them in like a predefined area. So like that. I don't know if I could do 2 blocks. What is he doing? And then I leave the area, right? And then they come back? Is what I'm assuming that they do. I don't know how many of these I need. So let me go like this, right? I want them to spawn. Right? Okay, yeah, he spawned. That zombie Pikmin's in the way. Come on, get out the way. I don't want to hurt you. I'm out of your cozy cage so I can hit you. No, I hit the wrong thing. He has to die. Now I have to be careful. Because everything else is going to start coming after me. Yeah, I totally forgot that I had a crossbow on me. Yes, sir. I'm sniping them out here. Look at this. That's easy gameplay right here. Oh my god, look at these sniping skills, bro. I should have done this a long time ago. What the hell? Oh my god, this thing does so much damage. I think I have enough. I have 11. I'm just trying to get 12. I'll get one more. Oh, my bow is a bit more powerful. But I did get my 12 blaze rod, and we could just leave now. Then we get silk touch. I'll just leave that there for now. Okay, we're home. And that makes me a happy boy. You know what doesn't make me a happy boy? This Enderman being in my house. And you leave. You know what? Pull up. Oh, I pull up. I run away. Mm-hmm, you can't come through here. You're not big enough. Ooh, he's trying to get me. Ooh, spooky. I pull up. Come here. Come here so I can lose this whole save. I pull up. I told you. Give me your block and your ender pearl. Thank you. Well, we're ready to go to the nether. We need to kill 12 more endermen for ender pearls. But after that, we are ready to face the ender dragon. And then finally get into the actual mod pack. Because all I've been doing is vanilla stuff. Plus a little quark stuff and like Minecraft plus things. So once we get that done, We are in the golden zone. But that's going to be it for me today. I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.